the other thing is like, what are the components which we have in e-commerce infrastructure? That is network infrastructure. That means that three infrastructure is there in the e-commerce. One is network infrastructure, that is what is called as information superhighway. That is what you call it as information goes much faster. Internet, local area network, wide area network, routers, telecom, cable TV, wireless, all those things which connects internet is called as internet infrastructure. And the next part is communication infrastructure, where messages and informations are getting distributed through various platforms like HTML, XML, email, hypertext transfer protocol, or HTTPS, which we have seen. So those are called as communication infrastructure. And the third one is domain infrastructure. That means that which talks about the business, common business infrastructure, its security, its authentication, electronic payment and receipt, directories, catalogs. So all those things come under. So the first one, network infrastructure, is hardware. Communication infrastructure is software. And domain infrastructure is business process. So that is how e-commerce infrastructure comes in. So web-based e-commerce architecture works like this. So you have a client, that is you and I, and we'll be connecting a web server that will connect to application server, that will connect to a database server, then it goes to database management system, then we get an answer. So this is how it works on. For example, if you type in Google, say for example, you want to know happy, so it will bring everything, whatever connects with the word happy. If you want to see what you call it as Paris, if you type Paris, it will bring everything. So this is how it works on, okay? And whenever we talk about infrastructure of e-commerce, there are three infrastructure which you have. One is the internet, the other one is World Wide Web, and the third one is web architecture. And there are some softwares which are there, like pull-push web coaching softwares. So Cobra, Corps, Java. Normally we use Java and V+, like Visual Basics, VB. So those things are some of the softwares which connects like e-commerce into picture. So with this little intro, as I told you that the components of e-commerce infrastructure is network infrastructure, I've explained, communication infrastructure, and domain infrastructure. Can I move on further? Hope you understood. Like, there are hardwares, there are softwares, and business process involved. And it is connected through this process. So now we need to understand levels of e-commerce infrastructure. So do you want to understand what is levels of e-commerce infrastructure? Like, once you understand the infrastructure, what level that e-commerce infrastructures are graded? Level 1, level 2, level 3, level 4, like that. So we will be seeing this. Are you able to see the screen? Yeah.
Yes, sir.
I'm just moving. So if you look, it's a small, don't worry about all those. Only few words I'm going to tell you. Enema. You can just zoom, okay? Internet economy conceptual framework. So this is what is called as internet economy. There are four levels on the top. You can see my cursor. What is the first layer? You have to understand. It is called as internet infrastructure. That means that any companies which are involved in creating the hardware, right? The networking hardware, and the basic software for the hardware. Like, you have a mobile and there is a Android which is required, right? The same day you have a laptop, the Windows or Linux or US is required, Linux is required. So that part is called as layer one. That is what is called as internet infrastructure, number one. Once it is ready, we will move on to layer two, which is called as internet applications infrastructure, where companies will give add-ons like software for website operation, right? Softwares for search engines, creating a search engine to look into. So that is what is called as level two. And layer three is called as internet intermediaries. Who are the internet intermediaries? Who provide services like BSNL, like Jio. So these are service providers. Docomo, these are service providers. So they come under the category of internet intermediaries because they are between that hardware and the human being which is connected. So internet intermediaries. And the last level is internet commerce. That is what we call as e-commerce. So in the e-commerce, companies are selling and buying only when you have that. So those companies are normally called as e-tailers. Those companies are normally called as e-tailers or manufacturers or service providers, anything. So that means that layer one is internet infrastructure. Layer two is internet application infrastructure. Layer three is internet intermediaries, company intermediaries. And the fourth level only, e-commerce can be performed on the internet. So this is what is called as internet economy. And one example I can give you is that Cisco, AT&T are the level one companies. For level two, we have Microsoft, IBM, Oracle, Adobe. So these are the people who develop softwares, right? They'll come under layer two. And like Yahoo, right? All those service providers like Yahoo, Bing, search engines like Google. So all those people will come under layer three as internet intermediaries. And in the last layer, internet commerce, we will have Amazon, Dell, right? Flipkart, Snapdeal, Alibaba, so eBay, all those companies will come in. You got a clarity now? Layer one, infrastructure. Layer two, internet applications, infrastructure. Layer three, internet intermediaries. Layer four, internet commerce, that is e-commerce. I got it? Can I move on? Guys, can I move on? Yeah. So till now,
what yes, we have sir, please seen, move.
Yeah, till now what we've seen is what is e-commerce infrastructure, what are the components of e-commerce infrastructure, and what are the levels of e-commerce infrastructure. The next thing we are going to do is planning for e-commerce infrastructure. How to plan it? If you want to have a, such a thing, the only thing is that sources. You need to plan what kind of hardware you need, what kind of software you need, and what kind of business process you are going to execute. So for that, you need to make a plan. Simple, right? It depends on the business. If it is a manufacturing business, what kind of hardware and software is required? If it is a banking business, what kind of hardware and software is required? If it is a, what you call it as, kind of insurance business, what kind of software and hardware is required? So if you make a plan on the sources, resources, then it is called as planning for e-commerce infrastructure. And final discussion on this topic, part number one is issues and roles of e-commerce infrastructure. What are the issues will come? One thing is that whether to have single website, whether to have more than one website, multiple sites, that will be the bigger problem. So that is why recently, you know that Flipkart has closed its website and they asked us only to go for mobile app. Why? Unnecessarily two things, centralized and decentralized. Whether the operation can be given to decentralized way to look into everyone, or whether it can be given in a centralized way. And most important is security, whether it is secure. That's the biggest problem. Like, we need to make e-commerce infrastructure as secure. If any breach is happening, then people will take all your information and cheat your financial information also. Beyond that, e-commerce infrastructure should be reliable. One example, simply I'll tell you. You buy a mobile and you see the entire night and keep it aside. In the morning when you woke up, if your mobile is not switching on, then that is not a reliable hardware, right? So you need to have a reliable hardware, reliable software. So when you have that, with all these, you need to plan to create your e-commerce infrastructure. Thank you. Mainu, are you able to see my presentation as well as my video? Correct? Right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, thank you. So we have completed discussion on the first part of our discussion in unit number three, that is e-commerce infrastructure. Hope you can take a screenshot, and this is what ultimately that you need to learn in this. And then moving on to our second part of discussion, I told three parts are there today. Second part is this, that is e-commerce models. So what are the models available? What are the models available? E-commerce model. So when you look into the e-commerce models, any idea what is e-commerce model? Any idea? Anybody? Any guess? Any guest dear? Friends, any idea what is e-commerce models? Okay, I'll move on. Are you able to see this now? I'm moving from PP to a Word file, PDF file. Are you able to see?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So these are the popular four models, my dear friends. B2B, B2C, C2C, C2B. Okay. I will explain you one by one what is it. Is it okay? Right. So we'll go and see the picture, then we can understand. Are you able to see this picture? This is what is called B2B business model. That means in the internet, if the seller business and buyer business, if the two business buys and sells, then it is called as business to business model. Normally we call it in marketing, do you remember that what you call it as institutional model. For example, you can see here one host product details. So in the website, the seller will put their details and the buyer will access that product information. Then buyer will place the order and the order will be received by the seller and they will dispatch the product. So let us understand seller is what you call it as. For example, if someone is buyer is a manufacturing company of cars. So they cannot make cars without their raw materials. So they have to get tires, they have to get iron and steel, they have to get nut and bolts, they have to get valves, they have to get engine, they have to get glass, everything. So if this business to make, which is going to make a car, is making an order in the internet, then that is what is called as business to business model, B2B model, business model. You got it? Can I move to the next model?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So this is called as business to consumer model. That is what we mean. We mean consumer is you and I, and there is a company. So company will host the people, consumer will access through the computer, which will be in the internet. They will place the order and we will get it. So B2B model, the best example we can say is Amazon, Flipkart. So all those things are B2B model, B2C model. Okay, you got it? Can I move to the third model? So this is called as C2C model, consumer to consumer model. What it means? Any idea? Did you remember a website called as OLX? What people do on OLX? OLX model. OLX, OLX, you have no website.
They will sell the old products, sir. And they will buy the product.
Great, ma'am. Great, ma'am. So that means that you will not buy from the business, but you will be selling to another consumer. So here, the seller also will be a consumer. The buyer also will be a consumer. Sometimes you need a facilitator. That facilitator is OLX, right? And the internet does the same thing. So if you have a product, you can also become a seller. So a consumer is converted as a seller. The popular thing is that buzzy.com. If you go to buzzy.com, you can get all those details, right? So this is this model. And the fourth model is consumer to business model. How is it comes? Consumer to business model. That means consumer will be the seller. They'll be selling to your business, right? For example, a Monster. The best example we can give it is Monster. So Monster is the company, but we are selling our resumes to Monster. And they will be buying your resume and they'll provide their services. So C2B. So these are the four popular models. Can you recollect what are the four popular models? Can anyone tell me what is the four popular models? Can you tell me what is the
business to business?
Okay.
Business to consumer.
Super.
Consumer to consumer.
Great.
Consumer to business.
Yeah, excellent. Thank you. Great. Perfect. So we'll move on. Only these models are not there. These are the basic models which are available, but there's another component which is coming in, government. If we have only business and consumer, it's okay. Now we have government with us. So we have G2G model. Government to government, state government to central government, one state government to another state government. If any transaction is happening, then it is called as government to government. And someone's mic is on, I suppose. Please switch off your mic, mute your mic. Thank you. So government to consumer, G2C. That means when it happens, for example, if you are paying a tax, if you are getting any concession, okay, if you are getting any scholarship, so government will give to you the consumers, then the consumer to government, C2G model. That means when you are paying a tax, as a consumer, you pay to the government. So G2G, G2C and C2G. That means what? In the first case, we have only business and consumer. In the second case, we have government and what you call as consumer. And one more thing, we have business also into that. So government to business. Government is giving loan to business, no? And that will come under government to G2B. And the business all paying taxes, right? So that will come under GST and all those taxes. That will come under business to government. So these are the first four and the next seven models. So 4 + 7, 11 models we have, right? Is there any model you can think beyond this? So totally we have 11 models. Is there anyone who can try that? Any other models you can think of? Any model beyond this? Can you create any model beyond this? It is between buying and selling, that's all. Anyone? Hello? Anybody is there?
Sir, brokerage.
Broker?
Broker model, sir.
Broker is also a business, right?
Yes, sir.
They will come under B, no?
Sir.
Yeah, that means there will be only three stakeholders. One is business, the other one is consumer, the other one is government. So all 11 models are built based connecting these three, correct?
Yes, sir.
But one more model is there. I'll give a clue. If you are doing everything on mobile, then what model we can say?
Digital model.
No, when you can create M2M, right? Mobile to mobile model, M2M or M-commerce we call it as. So we have discussed about e-commerce infrastructure. The second part we have discussed about e-commerce models. Can I move on to the third part of discussion? Right? The third part of discussion today is business applications of e-commerce. And these are the four important business applications which is happening. Four important business applications. And in that only I told you, 1, 2 and 3 is in the unit number 2 of your syllabus. And that EDI B2B, that is there in the unit number 4. We have clubbed and we have made it. Can we go ahead and understand each one separately? Yes?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Yeah. So let us first understand supply chain management. To understand supply chain management, I'll be taking you to another visual whereby you can understand. You got it here? Right. So what is supply chain management? It is nothing but logistics. Moving one product from the point of origin to point of consumption. Point of origin, the point of origin to the point of consumption. From the supplier to the company, company to the customer. That is what is called a supply chain. It is supplying and there is a chain. So supply chain management. In that, what are the things it is moved? One is raw material is moved between business to business. Work in progress is happening between business to business, finished product, business to consumer. You've got all the models here. Okay? So these are the flows. It is called as supply chain. And you have a picture. I'll show you the picture a little larger. You can see this. Okay? So you can see here. You can see all this picture. Like we have a suppliers. We have manufacturers, we have warehouse and distribution centers and customers. And when we connect all those people, we get certain costs like material costs, transportation costs, manufacturing costs, inventory costs. So all those put together, taking a decision on reducing the cost, improving the services is what is called as supply chain. Okay. I will show you another view, whatever we have taken. So this is what the model we have seen. In automation, first we have to plan. Next, we have to source where it is available. Then you have to manufacture, make. Once it is ready, you have to deliver. Once you are delivering it, people will buy it. What a point. So connecting all these like a chain to enhance the service and to reduce the cost is what is called as supply chain management or logistics and supply chain management. Is it clear? Right? Got a point there? What is supply chain management? Got a clarity?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. If you want to go for fully automated physical process, that is called a supply chain, is it possible without digitization? So digitization means automation. So you have to convert everything digitally. Whatever is available physically has to be converted digitally. For example, banks. Whatever physical process is available, banks has converted as digitized. So whenever you are digitizing, for example, your photo has to be digitized, your video has to be digitized, your voice has to be digitized, your writings has to be digitized, your forms has to be digitized, your order has to be digitized. So digitization is nothing but a process of automating the physical process. You take any business, whatever physical form it is, you need to convert into digital form. Today, if you want to buy a sari, rather than going to a shop, you can just view it in a website and take the model and you can order. That is what is called as digitization, right? For example, what is happening is like even you can gift everything. So that is what is automation of physical process is called as digitization. Only when you have a fully automated process, then only we can have a supply chain activity happening. If not, what will happen? You cannot order. And for that only that we have e-procurement process, electronic procurement process. How many of you know that all the government has government purchase, procurement, tender, everything has gone online? Is that anybody noted that? No physical process today. Every tender, every purchase, it is automated and people, government has to order online and they have to make a purchase. Do you know that? Now even business has gone to that level, right? Business has gone to that level. You make an order online. Not even you are using your phone. There is an application available. There are SAPs are available created by many companies. So those people, you can go for e-procurement. In the sense like all will happen. You see the product, you apply, you get your invoice and it is transmitted. So every process will happen. And the basic here is today, we got, maybe I want to show that, but unfortunately I couldn't have it. E-catalog has come in. Did you know what is catalog, my dear friends? Catalog, which will have details of the products and its prices. Now it has come in online. If you go to Dell website, you go to Dell catalog. It will be like a book. You can take page by page. Okay? That is what it is. Maybe I'll just try to show you. 1 second. Okay. I'll just try to show you. Presentation is going on. Dell catalog. I just type catalog. I just see whether it is possible to show you now. Dell become shopping list. Dell catalog. I'll just go ahead. Are you able to see my screen now? Because I have gone into the internet. I mean, the browsing.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. One second. I think it's getting up. Continue with India. Okay. It's taking a little slow. Wait. Let us see that. It will look good. Dell is taking to official website. It will be like a book. Digitally, you can move it. Oh God, it's getting late. Oh, catalogs. Very slow, very slow. Network is very slow. Not to move. Two seconds. Are they asking any help is required? Let's search now. Okay, fine. Maybe I'll go and show you both these. You can see that. Put these. Just add both these. This website. I can go to put these website. You can see colorful sarees you can order. So you have a catalog here, digital catalog. From there you can make a procurement. That's getting up. Okay, done. So you can just shop. So you see all are available. You have to go and pin it. So if you want sarees, must have. So here you can see. Sarees, maybe we can go for designer sarees. So everything is available digitally now. There is no need to get it. So designer sarees, it's coming in. Yeah, you can see here. So you can always move. You can see here. It can be moved and viewed whatever way you want. Okay. So this is what I just want to show. But Dell, you can always go ahead. Right. So that is what is called as e-procurement. Through digitization, we can get e-procurement. Okay. So first thing which we have seen, and the next one is e-marketing. E-marketing, the second out of four. In the third part, we are seeing what is e-marketing. So I think many of you know that if anything is promoted, anything is made available to the public by the company in an electronic mode is called as e-marketing. I'm taking you to the another slide. Okay. Are you able to see this? E-marketing slide?
Yes, sir.
So these are some of the e-marketing things which happens. We need to understand what is e-marketing. We need to understand what are the methods of e-marketing. We need to understand what are the strategies, what are the models, what are the advantages and disadvantages, what are the security concerns. That is what we are going to look at. So if you look into e-marketing is nothing but internet or online marketing. Maybe we can say marketing a brand in the internet and distributing your information, promoting about your companies. So that is what e-marketing is. So there are six popular methods are available. I'll show one by one. One is search engine marketing. That means if you go on search in the Google and you can just find what is available. So that is one is search engine marketing. So through search engine, you can just find out whatever details you want or products will be marketed. And the second one is display advertising. So you see here, Like this, whenever you browse, you get advertising, right? Like this, advertisement will come in. And the third one is email marketing. Many of you have an email. Whether you are getting unwanted mails from many business, especially health related emails, all those things will come in, right? Do you get it, that?
Yes, sir.
Yes, so that is email marketing. Through email, the business is promoted. And the fourth one is interactive advertising. The fourth one is interactive advertising in the sense like they will contact you through IM, instant messengers, and they'll be doing it. And the fifth one is blog marketing. That means every company creates a blog and they get all their followers and they promote it. And the sixth one is viral marketing. Even in the last session, I told you, we have been word of mouth. If you go to this shop, this will be good. If you go to that shop, that will be good. All those we'll be saying. No, now we are just giving a like, comment and share. So that is what is called as viral marketing. So one movie goes in such a viral, right? Anything which you do, it goes in a viral, all those things happen. So these are the methods which are available. But strategies, if you look in, you need to do market research and direct sales through that, email marketing. So all those strategies, you need to make it. And some of the business models like e-marketing, actually e-marketing is another side which promoted e-commerce. Because whenever you want to sell your product, they don't want to sell it physically, they want to go online. So when they want to go online for selling, we got e-commerce. Okay, so this is what it happens. And what are the advantages of marketing, e-marketing? You should know that all information is available. If you go to shop, the shop owner will tell you only little information, but all information is available in the website. You can browse, and it always saves money. The another advantage is that why unnecessarily we should take a bike, car, put a petrol, waste your time and go there. So it will save money. Expansion, like you can always expand the business, and it will be low cost. Initially to get laptop or mobile, it will be costlier. Later it is a low cost. And the advertising is efficient in this way. So that is one advantage. But there are disadvantages also.
Excuse me, sir. Sorry for interfering.
Anama?
Sir?
Yeah.
Sir, your voice is not audible, sir. Kindly please repeat it, sir.
Well, I will just check it out. Is it okay now? I think everything is fine, ma, from my end.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so maybe you may have little network problem. Please check it out. So I'm moving on. My presentation has gone out. Okay. There I was not here. I was somewhere else. Okay, e-commerce, e-marketing. So I was like dwelling upon e-marketing. So we are talking about disadvantages. So many people may not access the technology, so that's a disadvantage. Low connection speed. We have that problem. No, please, you see, whatever we are expressing, it will be like low connection speed, right? So another thing is a complication. Many of us may not understand the technology properly, usage of the technology, usage of the software. So usage, many people say that I was paying only 100 rupees, but it has taken 1,000 rupees. Unknowingly, you have pressed one more zero. You want to pay 1,000 and you have paid 1 lakh. So unknowingly, you have pressed 2. So the other is intangibility, the biggest disadvantage in, because we have a habit of touch and feel, right? We have a habit of touch and feel. If you want to buy anything, we want to touch and feel, then only we'll buy in India. But intangible, you cannot do anything. You have to info. You have to believe one, but it is very difficult to India. And the more important thing is that security concerns, privacy, encryption, description. If you put a message in WhatsApp, anybody can see in between. Now they are saying that it is encrypted, but I don't know how far it is true, right? And privacy, but we need to believe that WhatsApp is saying that it is encrypted. So another thing is that suddenly you get a call from someone and you have not given your number at all. What it means? That your data are sold, your numbers are sold, and they are using it. Okay, so these are the I'm clapping myself. Okay, so two things we have seen. One SEM, supply chain management. Number two, e-marketing. The other one is e-business. We have to see what is e-business. To understand that, we need to understand what is workflow management. So that means in a business, the there are so many workflows are there. So many workflows in the sense like each activity, if you take a bank, depositing is one workflow, withdrawal is another workflow, transfer is another workflow, taking a printout in the passbook is another workflow, making a payment is another workflow. Now what is happening, you know, when it comes to e-business, when you are physically doing it, there will be n number more, 200, 300 works will be there. But if you get into technology, some of the unwanted workflow will cut, right? So that is what is called as workflow. And if you want to do workflow management, you need to go for organizational restructuring. That means that already an organization is there where you need to restructure business process re-engineering. I discussed in the first session itself. Enterprise resource planning. So you have to replan your resources. You have to re-engineer your resources, business based on the technology, because you are entering into electronic business for electronic commerce. That we need to do. And the third important thing is that we need to make integrated logistics and distribution. Purchase is one inward logistics, selling is outward logistics. And if anything is coming back, it is called as reverse logistics. Got it? Whenever you purchase anything, it is inward logistics from the company angle you think. If you are selling from the company, it is outward logistics. Suppose if your product, you are buying a product, it is damaged, you have to return back. That is called as reverse logistics. So if you are able to connect inward logistics, outward logistics and reverse logistics, inbound logistics, outbound logistics, reverse logistics, then it is called as integrated logistics. That is now happening in electronic mode. For example, did anyone seen track and trace facility? Did you use track and trace facility whenever you go for ordering online? Did you use it? For example, you ordered through Amazon and you want to know where is your product. Are you able to check it in your Amazon app?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that is what is called an integrated logistics system. So they have made it more integrated. People are not aware, where is my product? Now they are giving instruction. Your product is packed. Your product is dispatched. Your product is crossing this city. Your products will reach on so and so date. It may come one day before. All the things are given, right? Okay. And for that, we need to go for mass customization. But usually we go for mass production. Did you hear about mass production? That means manufacturing more number of shirts, more number of chappals, more number of products, and they dump it to the public. That is what is called as mass production. After the Second World War, we had that. But because of technology, we are moving from mass production to mass customization, my dear friends. What is mass customization? For example, if you go to a shop, you will only have 6 or 7 models. And that means that they have made a survey and they make sure that everybody choose that one, mass customization. And even now, what is just personalization is happening. They will give you a product what you want. Only one product will be. Nowadays, even if you go and buy a stud to a shop, and if you ask, do you have another model? They'll say, madam, we have only one model. We don't have another model. How is it possible? Think of those days we get n number of things. Now they are saying, no, we have one model. That means what? They are focusing individual. And that is where the product differentiation comes. How many of you really buy what your friend has? For example, if your friend is wearing a garment like a chudi or a shirt, do you really want to buy the same shirt and chudi? Do you do that?
No, sir.
Huh? Yes or no?
No, sir.
No. Actually, if I have asked the same question 10 years before, do you know what was the answer? It was yes. they want to buy what others are using. Nowadays, what happens? You don't want to buy the same one. You want to buy something else and show that you have a difference. That is what is called as product differentiation. Today, that is why companies are, it's possible because you are moving towards variety, towards e-commerce. And the other one is knowledge management. You are suddenly getting a phone call, you are suddenly getting a WhatsApp message, you are suddenly getting an email from a company. How is it possible? And suddenly they'll send you. For example, if you are searching for a mobile for 1 week on the internet, the next day you will get an email from that company, various models. Did you got it like that? So based on your searches, they will send you information. Did anyone got like that any information? That means they are managing our information as a knowledge and they are taking decision. It is because of e-commerce. And the final one is eCRM. Today, all the customers are connected. All the customers are connected through electronic mode. They are not connected in a physical mode. Every information is sent. For example, did anyone bought medicine in Apollo or any other network medical shops? Not our local shops, network. Anyone bought medicine in Apollo? Apollo medicine? I mean, Apollo pharmacy? Anyone? No? No, you don't get it from Apollo pharmacy? Okay.
No, sir.
Once you get it, they will send a message. So you got this much money. Next time when you come, you can recoup it. You can deduct it. Maybe if you are regularly buying, for example, I buy medicine to my father. Every month, 2 days before, it will give an indication. Your tablets is going to get, what do you call as? Get over, why can't you come and shop? So that is what is called as e-commerce, my dear friends. Right? I think almost we are in time. Is it time, 6 o'clock? Is it?
4 minutes is more, sir.
4 minutes more, fine. So I want to take this EDI, but it's a bigger concept. We will reserve this concept in unit number 2. We will discuss tomorrow. Can it be okay?
Yes, sir.
Unit number 3, I am reserving only one concept, that is EDA and B2B. That we will discuss tomorrow. Then we will discuss unit number 4, that is e-banking. Can it be okay? Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah. So we will reserve that. If you have any 4 more minutes, if you have any doubts, I can answer you. Any doubts? If you have any doubts, I can answer you. Maybe till our next professor comes for online, so we can go ahead. Any questions? What all we have discussed? Maybe to sum up, today we have discussed on e-commerce, business models of e-commerce. Under that, we have discussed about e-commerce infrastructure. Then the second one, we have discussed about e-commerce models. And the third one, we have discussed about business application of e-commerce. Under that, we have discussed about supply chain management, e-marketing. Then we have discussed about business applications, like, supply chain management, then e-marketing. Then what we have discussed? One more. And the last one is EDA. Okay. Any doubts? Tomorrow, we will see some more videos on electronic banking. That way we can understand. If you have any doubts, and maybe the resources are available, you can follow your books also, right? If you have any doubts, you can ask me at any time. Last 2 minutes to go.
Sir, you were telling about business to consumer concept, no, sir?
Yeah.
Kindly please explain it, sir. I can't hear it properly. Business to consumer, business to business. Consumer,
right? B2C, you are asking me.
Yes, sir. B2C and B2B, sir.
Very simple, ma. Whatever we are doing now, if one business is buying from another business, it is B2B. One business is selling to another business, B2B. How it happens? One example. If anybody want to manufacture car, one company want to manufacture car. For that, they need raw materials like iron, steel, bolts, engine, valve, tire, everything they want, right? Bulb, everything. So they will buy it from another business, correct? That is called as B2B. What is B2C? What we are doing now? If you are going and taking a sari, or if you are going to buy a mobile from a business, then it is called as B2B, B2C. B is the seller and C is the buyer, right? And if the normal purchase, you go to a Kirana shop and you buy a milk packet, what it means? B2C. The same thing is happening in the electronic mode. That is why it is called as B2C model. Hope you know you got the point.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. Any other queries? Or do you have another session or this is a session? Because it's time. Hope I can leave, or I have to wait till the next resource person comes in. Let me wait. If you have any queries, this time can be utilized. Guys, what is your feedback about my class? Is it okay? Enjoyable?
Yes, sir.
Great.
Sir, another one though, sir.
Okay.
E-procurement. You are telling about e-procurement, no, sir?
Yeah. See, normally whenever anybody want to procure, what is the thing we'll do? We will get the catalog, we will see the products and its rates, then we will make an order, they will supply to you, they will give a sample, then they will supply to you, everything will happen. Now that process is made electronically. All government, it is mandatory now, they should go for e-procurement. All companies, they are going for e-procurement. That means all the payment, all the information, everything in electronic way. For example, if an institution want to order 50 systems, computers, it cannot buy manually. It should go for e-procurement. They have to go for DGST rate, and they have to order, and the electronic payment will be made, and they'll be getting it. That is what is called as e-procurement. Is it okay, Vinod? So hope it's time. Thank you. We'll meet tomorrow at 5 o'clock for our fourth session with the pending of today's discussion and e-banking. Is it okay? Take care.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Good evening, students. Now class is merchant banking and financial services. And Chandrasekhar sir is coming. He will be joining with you within 5 minutes. Kindly bear with this delay, 5 minutes delay. He is coming. Thank you. Whether I am audible, students, no response from your side.
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Okay. He is joining with you. And regarding this examination doubts and all, you are clarifying, no? Through WhatsApp.
Ma'am.
Hello, madam.
Yeah, any doubt?
Madam, exam date எப்போ madam fix பண்ணிக்கறாங்க?
எக்ஸாம் டேட் இன்னும் ஃபிக்ஸ் பண்ணலைங்க. ஆனா எக்ஸாம் வந்து டிசம்பர்ல தான் இருக்கும். டேட் வந்து will be intimated later. உங்களுக்கு 1 month க்கு முன்னாடியே டைம் டேபிள் வந்துரும் நெட்ல.
ஓகே மேம்.
ஓகேவா?
ஃபீஸ் பேமெண்ட்டும் நாங்க ஆன்லைன்லயே பண்ற மாதிரி இருக்கும்
மேம். ஆன்லைன் ஆஃப்லைன் இன்னும் not yet decidedங்க. Whether it is actually you are going to write online or offline, they are yet to decide.
But second year ku exam December nalla suggest
padichu
second year ku December exam ma'am
second year sir for second year exams actually yet to be decided. You have to wait until the circular comes.
Okay. Can you hear me, ma'am?